Movies, TV shows, and social media have succeeded in making a huge population of people obsessed with Milan City. With its glamour, high-end fashion, and elite lifestyle, this city has sneaked its way into the bucket lists of people all over the world. However, media perception tends to be missing out on some huge elements. While fashion, boutiques, and high-end clothing are some of the major elements of this city, but it is important to note that there's a lot more to explore as well. From different historical sites to tons of amazing tourist attractions, this fashion hub will keep you occupied and stunned with all that it has to offer. Are you thinking of paying a visit to the ever-so-famous Milan City shortly? If yes, then you are in the right place. Stick around to take a look at the top 12 places you must see for yourself when you visit the beautiful Milan City. Before we go to number 1, make sure hit that subscribe button for more videos like this one. And now the first place to visit in Milan. Number 1. Milan Cathedral, Duomo of Milan. Starting with one of the most famous and historical rich places in the city, the Milan Cathedral. This cathedral church is situated on Piazza del Duomo and has a lot for you to uncover. Known to be the third largest cathedral in all the existence of Earth, the construction of this cathedral took place in 1386, and it's said that it continued for 500 years till it was completed. It is an important historical and cultural site as the tombs of their very important saints are present in there. These tombs are Saint Gervasius, Saint Ambrose, and Saint Prutensis, housing approx 136 and around 2,000 marble statues. This place is rightly called the Marble Hedgehog. Be sure to pay a visit to the terrace for a mesmerizing and panoramic view of the city. Number 2. The Vittorio Emanuele Second Gallery, Galleria Vittorio Emanuele. Next up, after one of the biggest cathedrals, Milan is also housed to the oldest gallery for shopping in Italy. When making a tour itinerary, this one should be a necessity not just for the fashion element, but because it is a crucial landmark also. Moreover, it just takes a 5-minute walk to get to the Vittorio Emanuele Gallery from the cathedral. Named after an important figure, the first king of Italy, this spot was designed in the year 1861. This gallery has around 10 shops including Louis Vuitton and Gucci etc. and multiple cafes including Cafe Biffi, which is one of the oldest cafes ranging back to the 1867. Surely the shops and cafes will entertain you, but the architecture with a mosaic floor and a 48 meters dome is bound to leave your jaw hanging in awe. Number 3. Sforza Castle, Castello Sforzico. It is impossible to talk about Italy with its rich culture and not bring up castles in the meanwhile. One castle in the Milan city known as the Sforza Castle is one of the most historically crucial and aesthetically pleasing castles in Milan. There was a time back in the 12th century and 14th century as well, when this castle was the house to Sforza and Visconti families who were the rulers of Milan. Today open for tourists and general public, this castle has a bunch of museums and even the last piece of Michelangelo. All the museums together hold a huge amount of other important features and pieces of art such as armory weapons, decorative art, and the entire collection of history and antiques going back to the Egyptian and prehistoric times. Number 4. Park Sempione, Parco Sempione. The best thing about these locations in Milan is that if you follow or lust, you won't have to travel too much through vehicles. Right after getting out of the Sforza Castle, with just a little walk, you can enter the Parco Sempione, also known as Parco Sempione. One of the biggest parks accessible for the public and tourists, the Parco Sempione is a nice place to rest and take in the lively environment of Milan. The cleanliness where combined with the beauty of the architecture is surely bound to give you a calm and peaceful experience. Other than resting in the grass or on the benches, you can also take a look at the different buildings in the vicinity. This includes the Arena Civia, the Civic Aquarium of Milan, and the Triennale full of architecture, art, and history. Number 5. Arco della Pace. In the Park Sampeon, when you keep walking, you will discover various architectural wonders. One such wonder known all over Milan is the beautiful Arco della Pace. Surely, the locals and Italian viewers will be able to gauge the type of architecture from the word arco. This is a 25-minute high arc located in the northwestern area of Sampeon. Rich in history, this arc was designed and created back in 1807 and stands tall ever since. The arc wasn't just built without any purpose. Like all other buildings and monuments in Italy, this arch too was designed for a specific purpose. Back then, it was created to celebrate the presence of the famous Napoleon. Number 6. San Siro Stadium. Are you a fan of football? If so, then you will be having the time of your life in Milan. Any AC Milan fans out there would be delighted to know that the San Siro Stadium is situated in Milan. Stadium for AC Milan. This huge stadium can house around 80,000 people. This stadium is also known as the Stadium Giuseppe Meazza. Initially, this stadium back in the old days turned out to be too small and had to be renovated and rebuilt to make it greater in size. Even the opening match and the quarterfinal of World Cup 1990 have also been hosted on this magnificent and huge ground. The stadium has gone through several refurbishments and renovations to increase its ground size. Number 7. Navili Canals. Looking for some place to spice up your Instagram feed? Head over to Navili Canals. While the area has a lot of dams and canals for you to discover, you will also find yourself to be in a peaceful and beautiful neighborhood. While morning time is the best time to be there with the sun streaming in, the night time and evenings are equally good. Nighttime is the time when the bars and cafes open up, making it a lively and romantic place. Back in the old days, canals were used to move goods to the country and to transport food. Another great historical thing to note here is that this spot and system were designed by the ever so famous Leonardo da Vinci. Number 8. Church of St. Mary. Chiesa di Santa Maria delle Grazie. The next place for you to surely visit in the capital of Italy is the St. Mary Church. To make things even more special, it is crucial to note that the church has been declared as a World Heritage Site by UNESCO. Opened for the public back in 1497, the architects Donato Bramante and Gianforte Solari designed it. Furthermore, this beautiful church had the burials of Giovanni Marliani and Gilberto Borromeo. For any art enthusiast out there, if you want to take a look at the famous mural by Leonardo da Vinci called The Last Supper, then this is the place to be. The church had faced its fair share of troubles back during World War II. In 1943, an aerial bombardment damaged the refectory of the church. However, luckily the Last Supper survived. Number 9. La Scala Theatre. Teatro La Scala di Milano. You cannot possibly imagine touring Milan and not taking a look at the opera theaters and the opera houses, one such famous places to add your bucket list in the famous La Scala Theater, one of the most important theaters of all Italy. This one can be visited right after Galleria Vittorio Emanuele, as both of these are in close vicinity. The exterior might look quite simple, but the interior is bound to stun you due to its magnificence and splendor. Not just the theater, but you can also get a look at the Museum of La Scala. In this spot, you will be able to take a deep look at the musical culture, including costumes for opera, the instruments, and other documents as well. Number 10. Basilica of Santo Ambrogio. One of the oldest places open for tourism, the Basilica of Santo Ambrogio is known for the historical importance it holds. Back in the old days, and when we say old, we mean pretty old, considering how the church first came into existence in 386. However, the Basilica that we can see today was brought to completion in the year 1099. Named after a crucial patron saint of Milan City, think of this area as a secret spot, as there aren't many tourists that are aware of it. Once venturing inside, you will find that there are various saints, including Saint Protasis, Saint Ambrose, and Saint Gervasus. This Romanesque style of architecture will surely give you a great experience. Number 11. Monumental Cemetery. The next place on our list is bound to stun and maybe creep you out a bit too. However, if you really want to get the complete 360 degrees and view and tour of Milan City, then the cemetery is one place you wouldn't want to miss out on. The Cimitero Monumentale di Milano, also known as Monumental Cemetery for English travelers. The one thing to keep in mind while adding this place to your location is that it is not just a cemetery, as it has a lot more to offer. Like all other places in Milan and Italy, this place once again has a museum in it as well. In this museum, you will find a lot of artistic tombs. One thing you should keep in mind is that if you plan on visiting it, then do it on any type of days of the week other than Monday. Number 12. Pinacoteca di Brera. And here we are coming to an end with the Pinacoteca di Brera. This is a must-see, as this is the art gallery where you will get to take a look at some of the most important pieces of art in the history of Italy. Situated in Plaza Brera, this place is said to be designed and created on a monastery where monks used the spot for cultural teachers, schooling, and even as a library. Considering how the growth of the collection doesn't seem to be coming to an end, there are around 40 rooms in which the art is placed in chronological order. This too is done based on the technique of art used. And there you have it, folks. Those were the 12 most important places to visit in Milan City. Comment down below and let us know what your favorite spot is. Stay tuned for more interesting videos. Till then, goodbye.